All right, here we are for part two of my reaction to Ruby, volume 8, chapter 11. Quick reminder before we begin, hit the subscribe button and the notification bell. Your support's appreciated. Come join the pack. Right. You just calm down. Calm down, Crow. I know you. Look. Yeah. We get you're pissed about Clover. It was Winter and Mara, wasn't it? Here we go. Yeah. Yeah. I'm still, yeah. Don't do that, Ruby. Don't become that person. It's called trusting your feelings. Now what? Oh, please don't tell me. Oh, this is the last thing we need. No! No! Think of something! I'm with Emerald. Do something! Anything! No, anything but that! No. Right. There we go. That should at least hold it until... That should at least hold it until we can figure something out. That's right. Oh. If you're willing to hear him. Yeah, it's a big risk. Trust is a major risk. Who says it has to be her? It doesn't have to be her. So, really? We're ending it there? So what's the dealio? What's the plan here? Who says it actually has to be Penny going to the vault? We have Emerald on our side. is to say we can't at least beat it Ironwood at his own game. Or, since we know Watts and Cinder are since we know Watts, Cinder, and Neo will probably be going there as well, pit our enemies against each other. And while they're at it, well, we'll figure it out from there. But we gotta move quick, cuz we don't know how long it'll be before Salem pulls herself back together. I'm just glad that Emerald seems to be willing to switch sides now. She seems all right now, but that'll be tested when she comes across Cinder. And Ozpin has finally stopped running away. It's good. I like that. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already subscribed. Leave your comments down below and I will see you at my next reaction. I love you all, and there is nothing you can do about it. Until we meet again, adieu.